These are called mermaid tears. I collected them on the beach, but they're not rocks or little bits of shell. They're actually plastic. When plastic gets into the ocean, it gets broken down over time into smaller and smaller pieces. And once those pieces are less than 5 millimetres, it's called microplastic. And there's now so much microplastic in the world that it's finding its way into our food supply and into our bodies. This beach in Spain has 2,000 microplastics per kilo of sand. And I'm here to talk with Professor Jacquem, an expert in microplastics, to find out what all this means for our health. In one of his studies, he looked at microplastics in oysters and mussels. Because mussels and oysters are eaten whole, if there are any microplastics in them, you're going to ingest them. Here in the distance, you can see a local mussel farm. It stretches for miles. As we get closer, you'll be able to see all the ropes hanging down from the wood. Each one of these ropes has 30 to 40 kilos of mussels growing on it. Mussels are filter feeders, which means they filter the ocean water to get their food. So testing them gives us a good indication of how much microplastic is in the ocean.
How much microplastics are in them?
A lot. Every mussel have around 8 microplastics. Mm-hmm. And oysters around 12 microplastics. And 90% of these microplastics are fibers. Fibers from our clothes.
How's that getting into the ocean? Is that when we wash our clothes in the washing machine and it's then going into the wastewater?
Exactly. The wastewater treatment plants reduce this pollution in around 90%. Almost all the microplastics that are removed from the water ends to the sludge. In the countries that have a soil with low content of organic carbon, fertilize it with this sludge.
So then the microplastics are getting into the soil.
Okay, And from the soil, the microplastic move from all the compartments in the environment. We last around 500 years.
So it's affecting a lot of future generations, not just us. Someone who would typically eat like a reasonable amount of mussels over a year, how much does that equate to?
After 1 year, we eat around 4 or 5 meters long. This is for a normal population, the population that eat a lot of mussels, that like it very much, this long fiber arrive to 11 meters.
11 meters of microplastics in a year. Wow, that's a lot.
That's a lot of plastic.
Let me pause there for a sec. If you've looked into plastic pollution before, you may be wondering, why do the mussels mainly have fibres from clothing? Why are there not heaps of other microplastics in them? After all, there's lots of microplastic in the ocean. Some of it enters as tiny bits like paint chips, or the clothing fibres that we've already discussed, or rubber from car tyres. And then there's bigger plastic objects that get broken down into microplastics over time. Things like abandoned fishing gear. And, of course, plastic trash that we've all seen so many pictures of. And yes, 80% of this comes from 1% of rivers in the world. Boyanslat's interceptors are doing a great job of starting to address this issue, but he still needs heaps more support because 1% of rivers is actually a lot of rivers, 1,656 to be precise, and they each need an interceptor, cooperation from local government to run it, and local waste management facilities to correctly process all the waste that the interceptor collects. Interestingly, even though we can't see the plastic fibres from our clothes in the ocean because they're so small, they equate to the same amount of plastic that's coming in from about 320 of these rivers. That's a lot of fibres. Okay, so back to the mussel question, why are the mussels not getting filled with fragments from everything else? Well, it's simply because some microplastics float on the surface, others sink to the bottom, and some, like the fibres, hang around in the middle where the mussels are.
Are the microplastic levels here high in the oysters and the mussels, or are they the same?
No, this is not a problem of Spain or France. If we analyse it, these mussels in Australia or in China or in the United States, I guess that are similar levels.
Do we filter it out and it just goes out to the toilet, or is it getting into our bodies?
that there are a magical size of microplastic that it's around 100 micrometers. Mm-hmm. In that size, we can absorb it through the intestinal tract and reach the bloodstream. There are a lot of research now that they found in the blood, mm-hmm. they found in the liver, they found in the kidneys, and they're found in the placenta of the pregnant woman, and also they found in our brains.
And are there any studies yet that are saying if that's doing any damage? I remember reading something that the World Health Organization said, this is in 2022, so this is going back a couple of years. They said then the weight of scientific evidence provided by current studies on the adverse health effects on human health was low because of substantial limitations of the available information. And they went on to talk about that we needed more standardized methods and more studies, particularly on the smaller particles. And I think the European Food Safety said that they were a potential food safety issue, but the data was currently lacking. So is that still the case 2 years on, or are we still lacking?
When we start in 2017 to study microplastics, around 500 articles was published in the world. Today, more than 6,000 publications. There is still lack of data, but we now can observe that microplastics inflammate our bodies. The immunitary system of our body react to the presence of a strange particle and try and start to inflammate in order to fight against them. This is for sure it's true. Now we know that it's a fact. Yeah. Microplastic inflammate. But in March of this year, in March of 2025, a very interesting paper was published that this kind of pollutant, the microplastic, can obstruct the capillaries of our brain.
Before we get to that, I'd recommend that you learn a little bit of Spanish before coming here.
Hola. Hola. Y batido de mango y plátano, por favor. Gracias.
Today's sponsor, Babbel, is one of the top language learning apps in the world. I picked travel as my reason for learning, so Babbel customised the lessons for that. All these units have been designed by language teachers. It helps prepare you for real-life interactions.
¿Algo más?
Un café, por favor.
¿Con leche caliente o templada?
Sin leche.
Perfecto. Son 3,50 euros.
And
Gracias.
There's even a 20-day money-back guarantee if it's not the right fit for you.
What language would you like to learn? Click on the link below to get 60% off your subscription to Babbel. Now, back to microplastics.
Microplastic can obstruct the capillaries of our brain.
Will that increase the chance of stroke and all of that sort of issue as well?
This is the point. This is the worry of the scientist that made this study.
Have there been any other studies that have shown a sort of a definite link yet with microplastics, or are we waiting on that to come?
We are waiting on that, because now another point that we need more data to see if it's in the way that it's moving, that okay, we have the plastic is more than the polymeric matrix. There are a lot of additives inside the plastic. There are additives that are flame retardants that can cause you cancer, for example, carcinogenic chemicals. Also are endocrine disruptive chemicals that can interfere in your hormonal system, especially if you are a pregnant woman or you are a child. That the effects of these chemicals are quite well known. We don't know it yet how these chemicals can or not migrate from inside our plastic to our bodies, or also environmental pollutants that are lipophilic, pesticides, DDT, dioxins, and a lot of them can be and act as a Trojan horse. You eat the plastic, and then inside your body can migrate and yet posit to this.
So the things like those chemicals, they attach to the plastic?
They attach or absorb it.
Or absorb into the plastic, okay. Yeah. See, I was thinking the other way. When they go into the ocean, wouldn't all of the chemicals come off the plastic? But no, the plastic kind of holds onto it.
Can absorb and
right.
Can or not migrate in different. Inside our body, we have, in the stomach, we have pH.
Lots of acid, yeah.
Acidic pH, and maybe can leachate. It's not one single pollutant, it's a cocktail of pollutants.
So years ago when there were issues with DDT and then tobacco and all those things, it took 20 to 30 years of studies and data in order for new laws to be made to say this is not safe, like in order for places like the World Health Organization to be absolutely convinced. It had to be undeniable in lots of studies. Do you think that it's going to take that long for this, or do you think that the amount of data is getting close enough that laws will be made around this?
Now European Union will in 2 months will open a call for the researchers to try to elucidate all the health impact of microplastic pollution. Mm-hmm. This research will last 4-5 years. Yeah. After that, 4-5 years more to regulate. It's too late to protect the health of the people.
So in your opinion, even though it's going to take a long time to regulate it, from the data you've already seen, is there enough data just from what you've seen to go, this is a major health problem and this is a major issue? Or would you say we need more data before you could call that?
This is a major concern for the humanity. Mm. It's like lead in the environment and so on.
And for people who are watching and they want to know, okay, if I just avoid oysters and mussels, am I not getting any microplastics? What other foods have microplastics been found in?
I guess that all the food that now we're testing for microplastics, mm-hmm. we found it.
Right, so it's in all food?
In all food.
Okay, is it higher in any particular ones?
Maybe the highest levels are marine food. Mm-hmm. Seafood, fishes, and so on.
What about food that is packaged in plastic? Are we getting plastic off that into the food or no?
Yes, we didn't publish it yet because we are finalizing our research on that. All packaged drinks, mm-hmm. or plastic bottle drinks, have microplastic. Tap water, almost here in Spain, have around 3 or 4 level orders of magnitude below the bottled water.
So you should choose tap water over bottled water.
Tap water, please.
What if it's in glass and a glass bottle?
Also have microplastic, because it's not a problem of the bottle, it's a problem of how this water are processed and arrive inside the bottle.
Right, so in the actual processing and bottling, you're getting microplastics in there. I also read something curious to me that I wasn't expecting, was that a cup of tea has quite a lot of microplastics. Why is that?
The tea bags, yeah, are made of polyester.
Oh, really?
These are fragmented and these tea bags are emit.
So if someone used loose leaf tea and a metal infuser, yeah, they'd be better? Yeah.
The traditional methods have less microplastics than modern ones.
Plastic chopping boards, are they a big issue for people ingesting microplastics?
You see the marks, you see, yes, that you lost material in that. Mm. Where they go? To your food, finally, to your stomach. If you are lucky, these fragments are too big.
Yes.
To pass for your gastrointestinal tract, and but if not, you ingest it and be part of you forever.
Mm. I read somewhere that the current amount of plastic in the world, if you weighed that, it weighs more than the weight of all the animals. If you added all the animals, insects and humans together, our weight is less than the amount of plastic in the world. How are we going to deal with that amount of plastic that we've currently got? Even if we stopped producing today, how would we make sure that didn't end up as microplastics?
The plastic pollution problem is like a train that are coming to you. If you put in the middle of the trail and say stop, the train will continue. The problem will be smaller and smaller, but in fact, bigger.
based on what you already know, what changes have you made in your life and what would you suggest people watching do?
Drink tap water and try to reduce your plastic fingerprint. Use less packaging, less plastic clothes, and so on.
Thank you so much for your time and answering my many questions. I really appreciate it.
Thank you to you.
And thanks also to you, my subscribers. Let me know what you're going to do to try and reduce your intake of microplastics and also your use of plastic in general. Special thanks to my patrons for all of your support. It is really appreciated. Make it a great week by being kind to others, and I'll see you on Friday.